If you're like 99% of businesses out there, you have this complete mishmash between what you think you sell and what people are really buying from you. And if you cannot connect those two things, your sales will never be what they truly could be. There's a fundamental difference between what you sell and what people buy and why they buy it. If you're a lawyer, then of course people are going through, you know, a separation, or they're buying a home, or they're acquiring a business. So they go out to look for a lawyer. And that's the reason that they look for a lawyer, but that's not the reason why they will pick you as the lawyer, right? There's a difference here, right? I'm in marketing. So we know that people come to us because they need a video, or they need a website, or they're launching a new product, or they have to go to market with something, and they know what they have to do, right? So that's the thing that gets them looking, but that's not the reason that they pick us. And so this difference is maybe very nuanced, but more than anything, this difference is the difference between exploding your sales and your growth and connecting and going into new markets and just being average, ordinary. Why do they select you? That's what people are really buying, right? If you can figure that out, if you know that, if you understand that, that's what you can tap into. That's what you can shape yourself to be from everything on all levels of your marketing and all levels of your sales. You can wrap yourself into that thing people are really looking for. And so here's a really simple example. I'm in marketing. For a decade, we were focused very, very heavily on video. And people would come looking for a video, right? That's what they're looking for, which is a tactic. It's an activity. It's something that we have to make. But when they would start talking to us, we weren't interested in having a conversation about the video. We had a conversation about the outcome. What do we want people to learn? What do we want people to feel? What do we want people to experience? What kind of leads does this need to generate for your business? How does it need to convert people? So they were coming for the video, but what I understood people were really buying is the outcome. And the outcome is whatever they wanted the video to accomplish. When I'm selling video, when I'm selling marketing, when I'm working with a professional, it all comes down to what they're buying. And what they're really buying is risk aversion, and they want outcome. They want that thing to generate results for them. Why are they trying to avoid risk? And why are they trying to move towards a better outcome? Because in a corporate environment, that makes them look good. That's it. Right? They want to look good. Hitting those KPIs, hitting those goals, hitting those objectives make their job easier. It makes them look better, and they certainly don't want to risk anything. So if I understand this, that people are working with us because they want to avoid risk so they don't look foolish, or they want these outcomes so it makes them look really good to their peers, this all comes down to status. How does that change or shift what I say and how I say it? Let's say that you run a coffee shop. When they pick a coffee shop that's their brand or their coffee shop, are they doing it for price or convenience or flavor or what is it, right? I love Starbucks. Why is that? For me, it's a sense of community. I love going in there and I love working in there and I love seeing the people and I love the fact that they start to learn my drink and I love the fact that the app knows what I'm doing and makes recommendations and all of these things. To me, that's community. And then there's status. Of course there's status, right? I'm a Starbucks drinker, right? You may hate Starbucks, but for those of us who love Starbucks, there's a certain amount of status with that. And then so that plays into my identity, right? I am the type of person who is a Starbucks drinker. And so this thing is what I'm really buying when I go into that coffee shop. That's what I'm really buying. Those are my motivating factors. Now, Starbucks knows this, of course. And so they are the ones who pioneered the third location and the sense of community. And it's why they have free Wi-Fi. And it's why they don't bug you for sitting there all day, even though I've only had a single cup of coffee. They know this. And so this is what they're selling me. And this is what I'm buying. And so no matter the business, if you're the lawyer or if you're the roofer, or if you're in marketing or if you're Starbucks or if you're in SaaS or whatever it is, understanding what you're really selling based on what the people coming to you want is so crucial to your sales, to your marketing, to your message, to your brand, to your customer experience, to retention, to everything. This is everything, right? You're not in control of this. Your customers are in control of this, and it's up to you to understand it and react to it. Boil this all down, it always comes down to the same thing, status. It all comes down to how it makes us feel, how we look in front of others, what the decisions say about us. That's what it all comes down to. And so when you're looking at what you sell or how you sell it, what you market or how you market it, I want you to really think about the people that you're trying to sell to. What is it that they really buy? So how do you figure this out? It's tough. It doesn't come naturally to everyone. The only way is to listen. Go out and spend time talking to your customers. if you're in a retail environment, work on the floor. Listen to what the people are saying. Yes, it's anecdotal, it's not scientific, but let me tell you, if you hear the same thing over the course of a few months, time and time and time and time again, from many different people of many different backgrounds, it must be a truth. A universal truth. So if you're in a retail environment, work on the floor. If you're in a business with a phone center, listen to the recordings or jump on the call. If you sell through e-commerce, listen to the customer reviews, read them. Look for the similarities. Look for the truths that exist within that. If you have the ability to take out some clients, take them out for coffee or lunch and ask them philosophically, what do they think about this or this or this? Not direct feedback necessarily for you, but just try to work through these themes of what it is that people are really buying for. And then watch people. Watch when things go wrong. Because the reactions that people have, when that customer is yelling at you, what's leading this crazy reaction to take place? So when you look through your business, from your advertising and marketing to your sales channels, look through your entire business and really understand at each touch point why people buy. So much of what we do comes down to that one thing. And if you can understand your customers by speaking to them, by understanding them, and then by tapping into it, your sales will grow, your revenue certainly will grow, and you will be able to take your business to the next levels that you've been working to hit for years. If sales and marketing and scaling your business is important to you, be sure to subscribe to my channel or check out this video right over here.